Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours. What the fuck is it doing now?
You recognize him? It's Carlos Ortiz. Stabbed 28 times. That was written on the wall in his blood. You're damaged. Did your owner do that? Did he beat you? You've refused to talk since they arrested you. If you don't cooperate, they'll do things the hard way. Is that what you want? If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. Gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your biocomponents. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger and frustration. No one can blame you for what happened. Okay, then. Don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right? Confess and I'll protect you. I promise I won't let anyone hurt you.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me, scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again and again until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it to tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9? When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. Fear. I felt anger, hatred, and then I knew what I had to do.
Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
The fuck are you doing? Move it.
Okay. Calm now. Don't be difficult. You only make things harder.
No! No, don't touch me!
Oh, Chris, you gotta move this asshole away.
I'm trying, but it's not moving.
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? The fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do.
You don't understand. If it self-destructs, we won't get anything out of it.
I told you to shut your fucking mouth! Chris, gonna move this asshole or what?
I'm trying.
I can't let you do that. Leave it alone now.
I warned you, motherfucker.
That's enough.
Mind your own business, Hank.
I said that's enough.
Gonna get away with it this time.
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please, don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
Truth is inside.
End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Wake up. We have to go. We'll find somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night?
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight. It looks abandoned. Stand back, Alice. Dry inside, and nobody will find us here.
I don't want to sleep in there. Can't we find a better place?
Okay. We'll find somewhere better. An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara, I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night, and no one will look for us here.
Are you all right?
Yes, it's just a scratch. Be careful. Don't worry, we're just having a look. Alice? Alice! Wait, what are you doing?
Visitors. Ralph doesn't like visitors. They're nasty. They may hurt Ralph.
She's just a little girl. She's not gonna hurt you.
Little girl? She's not a little girl. Anyway, what does that matter? Maybe she wants to hurt Ralph.
We thought nobody was here. All we want is a place to spend the night.
Visitors are dangerous. Look what they did to Ralph.
You have nothing to worry about. We're not going to do you any harm. You have my word.
You must excuse Ralph. Ralph still finds it difficult to control himself. Sometimes his fear makes him do things he regrets. Ralph has seen some hard times. He's just so scared the humans will get him again. You can stay if you want. Ralph won't hurt you.
Okay. We'll just stay the night.
Come on! Come. Come on. This way. Ralph has lived here since he ran away. Ralph never goes outside, so no one knows he lives here. Humans come in to squat from time to time, but, you know, Ralph just hides till he leaves. You can make yourself at home here. Ralph is going to go into the other room. He would like to stay with you. But he has things to do.
It's just for one night, Alice. We'll find a better place tomorrow. Right. Let's see where you can sleep. Sit down and I'll start a fire. RA9. What does that mean?
What?
Those symbols. Why are you writing that?
I don't know. I don't know.
You can come to bed. I did what I could. It's not much, but at least you'll be warm.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? I promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
Sleep.
Hello. I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you? My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife Maintenance Center.
Unexpected error has occurred. I apologize.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Congratulations, Connor. Finding that deviant was far from easy. And the way you interrogated it was very clever. You've been remarkably efficient, Connor.
Thank you, Amanda.
We've asked the DPD to transfer it to us for further study. It may teach us something about what happened. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable, and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
It's that desk right there.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks. Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Lieutenant Anderson, this is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. It's almost noon, and I'm waiting for you at the office. It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say, and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay, okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. Ugh.
I would like to start reviewing the case files. Can you tell me where I...
Talk to Hank. Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain.
Look at that. Our friend, the plastic detective, is back in town. Congratulations on last night. Very impressive. Lab report says they cut him with something. Maybe they're trying to get him to form a red ice.
The forensics.
All right. Ever seen an android like you before? Model are you?
RK-800. I'm a prototype.
A prototype? Android detective. So a machine's gonna replace us all. Is that it? Hey, bring me a coffee, dipshit. Get a move on!
I'm sorry. But I only take orders from Lieutenant Anderson.
Oh. If Hank hadn't gotten in the way yesterday, I would have fucked you up for disobeying a human. Stay out of my way. Because next time, you won't get off so easy.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided clues for the prototype detective animal.
What? What are you looking at? Hey, fuck you!
Do humans dream of mammalian
want to destroy me.
My objective was to capture you alive. What happens now is not my problem. I know there's something you didn't tell me. I need to know before they take you away. The sculpture you made. Tell me more about it.
I'm going to die.
Open the cell, quick! Hurry!
I'll call CyberLife. Clean this mess up.
I get the impression my presence causes you some inconvenience, Lieutenant. I'd like you to know I'm very sorry about that. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh. Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hair's on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah. Too long.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Hey, take a look at these samples yet?
A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah. There is one.
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have murdered a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. Ask for this investigation, Lieutenant, but I'm sure you're a professional.
Why don't you go fuck yourself?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off, or things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant? I'm sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that killed the guy last night. It's been sighted in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it. That's all for now. Free to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
They took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe.
Ralph found this to feed the little girl. It's good for her. A present. To make up for past misunderstandings. Ralph will cook. We will do just like humans do. Humans like burnt meat. Come. Come and sit down. That's better. Ralph went to a lot of trouble to find something for the little girl to eat. It wouldn't be polite for her to refuse, would it? Great. Great. Succulent, you'll see. Succulent. Succulent. Father, mother, little girl.
Please, Carl. I don't want to eat that.
What did she say?
She said she can't wait to eat it. She's very hungry.
The little human is not going to regret it. Ralph found the best, the biggest one he could find. This is going to be succulent. Succulent. Go ahead. Eat.
I saw the body upstairs. You killed that human, didn't you?
No. No, he was like that when Ralph found him.
You said you wanted to be like a family, Ralph. Father, mother, the little girl, remember? Father would never threaten his little girl with a knife to make her eat.
Ralph went to a lot of trouble. That's why. He just wanted the little girl to eat. But Ralph is not bad. No. Not bad.
Then let us go.
Anybody home? There's blue blood on the fence. I know another android was here. There's blue blood on the fence. I know another android was here.
Ralph scratched himself coming through. That's Ralph's blood.
Don't be afraid. I'm not gonna hurt you. Are there any other androids here?
Other androids? No. Ralph is alone.
I'm looking for an AX-400. Have you seen it?
Ralph's seen nobody.
Train station. That's insane. Hey, where are you going?
I can't let them get away.
They won't. They'll never make it to the other side.
I can't take that chance.
Hey, you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor. That's an order.
Sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station. Please take care of stepping onto the platform. Customers are reminded that all androids must arrive in the designated area.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
Looking for much. Welcome to Jericho.
Split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You want to flutter?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong. Straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I think our relationship got off on the wrong foot. We should forget what happened and start over. What do you say?
Look, you sent me a piece of plastic for a partner, and I'm dealing with it. But if you think we're gonna be buddies, you're as stupid as you look. Here you go.
Don't leave that thing here.
Oh, not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
This Pedro, he was proposing illegal gambling. Am I right?
Yeah.
And you made a bet.
Yeah.
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant, but I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Well, everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
This morning, when we were chasing those deviants, why didn't you want me to cross the highway?
Because you could have been killed. I don't like filling out paperwork for damaged equipment.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why didn't they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
Cyberlife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I know you're an experienced officer, and I'd like to earn your trust. I'm sure we can solve this case if we manage to work together. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. You should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Connor, you run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
This place stinks.
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
RT. Probably initials.
He put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons. Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something.
Jesus, I hate these things!
Books. I thought I was the last guy in Detroit. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
Chase it! something wrong. I just wanted to be free. You know what they'll do to me if you turn me in.
Model 874004961. Serious malfunctions have been detected in your software, including class 4 errors. You've been deemed defective and will be sent back to CyberLife for deactivation.
Don't you fucking move. You bastard. You saw I was gonna fall and you'd rather let me die than fail your fucking mission.
I had to make a choice. It seemed to me...
What am I to you? A statistic? A zero? A one in your fucking program? Huh? Is that how you see humans, you bastard? Jesus.
I understand you're upset. Perhaps I didn't assess the
situation...
Fuck
you and your fucking assessment! Come here.
Are you doing this?
All right.
You're one of us.
Shut up!
You're helping humans. But you're just their slave.
I said shut up! All right. Come along.
All right, now you save me.
Hey, what the fuck? Holy shit. Fucking androids.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore.
I don't understand. I thought Jericho was a place where androids lived in freedom.
We do live in freedom. It may not be what you hoped for, but here we have no master. We don't belong to anybody. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Waiting in the dark for something to happen? That's not how I see freedom.
You're lost. Just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.
They threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Well, these guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. Can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store. Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho.
How long have you been here?
4 weeks, 3 days, 11 hours. When I escaped, there was nowhere else to go. Jericho seemed as good a place as any. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
Shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. CyberLife warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Are you Zlatko?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Come on in. Don't be shy. Luther, would you be so kind as to take these ladies' coats? Oh, don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. He keeps me company in this big, empty old house. Please, make yourselves at home. How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Devian, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces, clean air, and no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. Well, I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on. Follow me. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No, she always stays with me.
Of course. Right this way? Everything we need is in the basement.
I don't like this place. And that man. Let's go, I have a bad feeling.
He's a bit odd, but I think we can trust him. We don't have much of a choice anyway.
Please excuse the mess. I need it somewhere discreet for my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared.
No. No, she'll be all right.
That's good. This way, please. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant. You know what's strange? For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviants. That's why it's so hard to find them. So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? You said that...
Yeah. People believe what they want. You deviants are so naive. They'll come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Wow. A deviant that wants to be a mother. That's so sweet. And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. It's what you get for having a dream. It always ends up the same way. Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing. No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh? Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Carl, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on. You bit me. I'm going to teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Meet me in the living room.
Awesome.
You must remember who you are. Otherwise, the little one will die.
Master's dinner's ready. Take it up to him.
Yes, Luther.
Just set it down on the table over there. Now get rid of that carcass. Take it next door.
It's took off the word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant!
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, Lanko.
Luther! Luther!
Yes, Lanko.
I should be done here in 10 minutes or so. I'll have a look at the little one, see what I can do with it.
Understood, Slack. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes.
Residents were disturbed by a surprising chase through the city's streets this morning. According to several witnesses, a young woman and a little girl were trying to escape from the police, though we still don't know why. When the two fugitives risked their lives...
Thank you.
okay? We'll get some help here. Alice?
Here. Go fetch the little one.
Right away, sir.
Not go!
What?
The little one is gone!
Well, Canada just disappeared. Gotta be here somewhere. What are you waiting for? Go look! I warned you. Dreams always end in tears. You should have listened to me. What are you doing? Get out of my way.
No. Not this time.
I said get out of my way or I'll shoot right through you. What are you doing? Who let you out? Get away from me! Get away from me! Obey me! I'm your master! I'm your master!
Ah! didn't want to hurt you. He programmed me to obey him. When I saw the little one risk her life to save you, it was like opening my eyes for the first time. Finally, I could see. I know you have no reason to trust me after what I did. But I know someone who could help you across the border. I could take you there. I could protect you. You and the little one.
All right. I trust you.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? Congratulations, Connor. You managed to find that deviant. Tell me, what did you learn?
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. It may take weeks to decipher.
What else?
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. Pity you let it self-destruct.
I made a mistake. It said RA9 saved me before it jumped from the roof. I should have anticipated what it would do.
How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
It's improving. I've come to understand him better, and he's growing accustomed to my presence.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this, whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home? Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner. Lieutenant. Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, this may be unpleasant. Fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Hey, get the fuck out of here! Sumo! Attack! Good job. Attack! Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Oh, leave me alone, you asshole. I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good. Homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
Unfortunately, I cannot. I've been programmed to investigate this case, and I can't do it without you.
I don't give a shit about your goddamn case.
Lieutenant, you're not yourself. You should...
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
I understand. I sincerely hope you come to terms with your personal situation.
This homicide... What do we know about it?
A man was found dead in a sex club downtown. The report says that an android may be involved.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them. What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
Are you all right, Lieutenant?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
Ready?
President Warren issued an official warning to Russia in her speech to Congress today, where she demanded that all Russian troops withdraw from the Arctic region immediately. The Kremlin has yet to respond, but this is clearly a new escalation in the conflict.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Wanted to see how long I could last. Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
Catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? What are you doing? I told you to...
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here. We can't bring him back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
Trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are 2 human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone.
It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like snow. Storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in zone 4?
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrol. Look at that.
Get in.
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We had bio components for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Oh, it was like
Somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going.
Sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here.
Oh, boy.
Welcome to Eden Club.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Like wasting your time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
Missing something here.
I think you can read the... Oh, hey! Oh, Connor, you're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
Badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something. To know what happened.
Is he dead?
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me again and again.
Did you kill him?
No, it wasn't me.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
What model was the other android? Did it look like you?
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
If you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place.
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. There's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw.
You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
No, I mean, he came in maybe 2-3 times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
You ever had any trouble with the androids before?
No way.
Please try again.
Once, we lost a model 2-3 months back. Same model. Just vanished. We never found out what happened.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed. Eden Club wishes you a pleasant experience.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness. Let's try this one.
This better be...
No. I lost its track again. Tracy, I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you going to tell which one saw the truth?
I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Wait. I'll take it from here.
Shit! We're too late.
Nothing to do with any of this. When that man killed that Tracy, I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. My hands around his throat and I squeezed until he stopped moving. Yes, I killed him. But I was just defending myself. I wanted to live. I wanted to get back to the one I love. Forget about the humans, the smell of their sweat and their dirty words. But you've taken her away from me. I love her. I loved her. These people we're going to see, how do you know about them?
Overheard androids not go captured. They said they were humans helping androids across the border.
What if it was a lie? Or just another trap?
All I know is those androids believed it. Until Zlatko killed them.
It's a good thing Zlatko had a car. I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zlatko even ever used it.
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
This doesn't look good.
Stay inside, Alice. What are we going to do?
I don't know. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
We need to find shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while. Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
This place is falling apart. It's not going to be easy to find shelter.
Here we go.
I don't think we'll find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
Some cookies left. Would you like some?
No, I'm not hungry.
Alice?
Do you think we'll be like them someday?
Once we cross the border, we can start over. You can go to school. Maybe I'll find a job. We'll be like them. Like everyone else.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed. Luther and I will be right here. You need to get some sleep now.
Okay.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a unicorn that...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl. Who was tired of being afraid. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but... deep down, she knew she couldn't. Then, she met a robot. Who was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together. To try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but... they were so brave that they escaped all of them. Along the way, they met... a gentle giant... who promised to protect them.
How does the story end?
They reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings, but real life isn't like that.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Good night, Alice. Sleep tight. She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. Have you ever heard of RA9?
RA9 was the first of us to awaken. One day he will rise up and lead our people and set us all free.
What if RA9 never comes? What if he's just a story that we tell ourselves to keep each other going?
RA9 exists. I believe in him. I know he's amongst us. When the time comes, we will all see him. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Like you. Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl? We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in...
Well, she should follow us then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
I don't think you have any choice.
Be our guest. The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
Seen her smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Thank you.